Bodhidharma never wrote anything in his life. In fact, no enlightened being has ever written anything. But there are three books attributed to Bodhidharma written by his disciples. We know about him through these books. Bodhidharma was born 14 centuries ago as a son of a Pallava king in Kancheepuram in South India. When he grew up, he renounced the kingdom. He was not against the world, but he was not ready to waste his time in mundane affairs. He told his father, "Let me go in search of something that is beyond death." Bodhidharma was a follower of Gautam Buddha, but you must understand that in some instances, he shows higher flights than Gautam Buddha himself. Bodhidharma got initiated by an enlightened woman, Pragyatara. Nothing much is known about her. She asked Bodhidharma to go to China. China had lived under the influence of a man called Confucius. Confucius is just a moralist. He does not know anything about the inner mysteries of life. He was not even close to enlightenment. Hence, his influence created a big vacuum. There were great people like Lao Tzu, Chan Tzu, Li Tzu, but they were mystics, not masters. They remained in their monasteries with their few disciples, so the vacuum persisted, and there was a spiritual thirst among the people. When Buddhism reached China, it immediately entered to the very soul of the people. The Buddhist people who had reached there before Bodhidharma had made a great impact, although none of them were enlightened. And now China needed another Gautam Buddha. The ground was ready. That is why Pragyatara, his master, asked him to go to China. Bodhidharma was the first enlightened man to reach China. When he reached there, 600 years after the entry of Buddhism, there were already 30,000 Buddhist temples, monasteries, and 2 million Buddhist monks. When he reached China, Emperor Wu came to receive him. Wu had done great service to the philosophy of Gautam Buddha. He had made thousands of temples and monasteries, and he was feeding thousands of monks. His first question to Bodhidharma was, "I have put my whole empire and its treasures in the service of Gautam Buddha. What is going to be my reward?" And Bodhidharma said, "Nothing, no reward. On the contrary, be ready to fall into the seventh hell." Upon hearing this, Emperor Wu was shocked. Bodhidharma said, "You have not yet heard your inner voice. If you had heard it, you would not have asked such a stupid question." Wu said, "I cannot hear what you are calling the inner voice. I don't know anything about it." Bodhidharma said, "Then 4 o'clock in the morning, come alone to the temple in the mountains where I am going to stay, and I will put your mind at peace forever." Emperor Wu reached the temple at 4 o'clock, early in the morning, in darkness, alone, and Bodhidharma was standing there with his staff. Just on the steps, he looked very ferocious, like a lion, and had very big eyes. He said, "Sit down and close your eyes. I am sitting in front of you with my staff. Your work is to catch hold of the mind. Just close your eyes and go inside looking for it. Where it is, the moment you catch hold of it, just tell me, 'Here it is,' and my staff will do the remaining thing." There have been many enlightened people, but Bodhidharma stands aloof, alone, like an Everest. His every act is unique and original. His every gesture has his own signature. It is not borrowed. Wu tried hard to look for the mind, and for the first time, he could not find the mind. It is a small strategy. Mind exists only because you are never aware of it. When you are looking for it, you become aware of it, and the awareness surely kills it completely. Hours passed, and the sun was rising in the silent mountains with a cool breeze. Bodhidharma could see on the face of Emperor Wu such peace, such silence, such stillness, as if he was a statue. He shook him and asked, "It has been a long time. Have you found the mind?" Wu said, "Without using your staff, you have pacified my mind completely. I don't have any mind, and I have heard the inner voice about which you talked. you have transformed me without doing anything. Bodhidharma said, you are a rare person. I love you. I respect you. Not as an emperor, but as a man who has the courage just in a single sitting to bring so much awareness, so much light that all darkness of the mind disappears. Wu persuaded him to come to the palace, but Bodhidharma rejected the offer. He preferred to remain in the wilderness. He lived on this mountain whose name was Toy. He was meditating almost all the time, and sometimes in the night he would start falling asleep. So just not to fall asleep, he started using certain leaves. They are nothing but the tea leaves. Bodhidharma was the first man who prepared tea. The name tea comes from the mountain name, which is Toy. That's why when you drink tea, you don't get sleep. And in Buddhism, it became a routine that for meditation, tea is immensely helpful, for it keeps you alert and awake. It took him almost 9 years to find his first disciple, Huiko. For 9 years, after sending Wu back to the palace, he sat before the temple wall, facing the wall. He made it a great meditation. He would just simply go on looking at the wall. Now, looking at the wall for a long time, you cannot think. Slowly, slowly, just like the wall, your mind screen also becomes empty. People used to come and they would sit behind him. It was a strange situation. People would be sitting behind him, but he would not face the audience. He said, nobody understands. And to look at human beings in such an ignorant state hurts deeply. But to look at the wall, there is no question. A wall is, after all, a wall. It cannot hear, so there is no need to be hurt. Then came this young man, Huiko. He cut off one of his hands with a sword and threw the hand before Bodhidharma and said, this is the beginning. Either you turn or my head will be falling before you. I am going to cut my head too. Bodhidharma turned and said, you are really a man worthy of me. No need to cut the head. We have to use it. This man, Huiko, became his first disciple. In China, he was known as Damo. Gautama the Buddha taught Dhyan. Bodhidharma transported Dhyan to China, where it became Chan. This Chan went further down to Indonesia, Japan, and other far eastern countries, where it became Zen. Bodhidharma is saying, don't be antagonistic to suffering. Even feel grateful to suffering. That is a great idea. Suffering creates the need for a search to know the truth. Bodhidharma has insights which are unparalleled. There have been many disciples of Gautam Buddha who have attained to enlightenment, but nobody has such great insightfulness. Except for Bodhidharma, nobody else has been able to make statements with great insights. They are so strange and look so illogical, irrational, but existence itself is illogical. If you are only thinking in the mind, then it is one thing, but if you are experiencing a transformation, the process of mud transforming into a lotus flower, you will understand Bodhidharma without any difficulty. You will rejoice in his strange statements. He also began the physical training of the monks of Shaolin monastery that led to the creation of Kung Fu. Finally, when he left China, or intended to leave China, he called his 4 disciples. 3 more he gathered after Huiko. He asked them, in simple words, in small sentences, telegraphic, tell me the essence of my teachings. I intend to leave tomorrow morning to go back to the Himalayas, and I want to choose from 4 of you, 1 as my successor. The first man said, your teaching is of going beyond mind, of being absolutely silent, and then everything starts happening on its own accord. Bodhidharma said, you are not wrong, but you don't satisfy me. You just have my skin. The second one said, to know that I am not and only existence is your fundamental teaching. Bodhidharma said, a little better, but not up to my standard. You have my bones. Sit down. And the third one said, nothing can be said about it. No word is capable of saying anything about it. Bodhidharma said, good, but you have said already something about it. You have contradicted yourself. Just sit down. You have my marrow. And the fourth was his first disciple, Huiko, who simply fell at Bodhidharma's feet without saying a word, tears rolling down from his eyes. Bodhidharma said, "You have said it without words. You are going to be my successor." Bodhidharma was also poisoned for speaking the truth, like Jesus, like Socrates. Although the people who poisoned him thought that he was killed, he was not. He was made of a different kind of matter. He simply went into a coma, and in the night he disappeared, leaving one of his shoes in the tomb and the other shoe hanging on his staff. He wanted to die in the Himalayas. He wanted that there should be no tomb, no temple, no statue of him. He did not want to leave any footprints behind him to be worshipped. He wanted those who love him should enter their own being. He disappeared almost in thin air. Nobody heard anything about him. What happened, where he died? He must be buried in the eternal snows of the Himalayas somewhere. Thank you for watching this video. If you love this video, please share it with your friends. Subscribe to my channel for more interesting videos. Thank you.